Hello, welcome to Ashish tutorial. I am Ashish. So this is part 1 of this video series. In this video series, you will learn about the basic as well as the advanced concept of Ashish programming. In this tutorial, I'll cover these topics like what is Ashish, why to use Ashish, features of Ashish, what is .NET framework and the components of the .NET framework. Okay, so let's come to prerequisites. So Ashish programming is very much based on C and C++ programming languages. So if you have a basic understanding of C or C++ programming, then it will be really easy for you to understand Ashish. Okay, so let's get started with the first topic, that is what is Ashish. So Ashish is a simple modern object-oriented programming language developed by Microsoft within its .NET initiative led by Anders Hejlsberg. Okay, so when Microsoft was developing .NET framework, then Anders Hejlsberg just took this initiative to develop Ashish. Okay, and Ashish was designed to run on .NET framework. The first version of Ashish was released in 2002 and the latest version, which is Ashish 8, was released in September 2019. Alright, now the second topic is why to use Ashish. So there are several reasons to use Ashish. I have mentioned few important points here. Like, the first reason is it is one of the most popular programming language in the world. It means it is more demanding nowadays. So more demanding means you will have a lot of job opportunities. Alright, the second reason is it is easy to learn and simple to use. The third is it has a huge community support. The fourth, which is most important, that is Ashish is an object-oriented language which gives a clear structure to program and allows code to be reused and lowering development cost. Alright, and the last is, as Ashish is close to C, C++ and Java, so it makes it easy for programmer to switch to Ashish or vice versa. Now let's discuss about the third topic, which is features of Ashish. So there are a lot of features of Ashish. I have mentioned few of them. Like here you can see, the first is automatic garbage collection. It means your unused object, unused Ashish object, will be automatically garbage collected using .NET framework CLR. Okay, the second is you can have assembly versioning, you can have a property and events in Ashish, you will have a delegates and event management, you can use generic in a very easy way, and you can use indexes, simple multi-threading, and it also supports, you know, link queue and lambda expressions. Okay, now let's come to the fourth topic, which is what is .NET framework. So the .NET framework is a revolutionary platform that helps you to write the several types of application, like Windows application, web services and mobile applications, lots of things you can develop using .NET framework. Okay, so the framework has been designed in a such a way that it can be used from any of the following languages like C, Ashish, C++, Visual Basic, JavaScript, COBOL, etc. And all these languages can access the framework as well as communicate with each other. Alright, and .NET framework supports more than 30 languages. Okay, so in short, you just need to remember that the .NET framework is used to develop several kinds of application like Windows application, web services and mobile application, and it supports more than 30 plus languages you can use in .NET framework. Okay, now the last one is the components of .NET framework. So as you know, using the .NET framework you can develop several kinds of applications, so it must be built up of several components that's gonna provide their services to build an application. Like if you have a bike, then bike is built up of several components like fuel tank, you will have an engine, gear, tires, clutch, etc. So similarly, .NET framework also have several components. Like if you see, the first one is common language runtime, which further going to provide several kinds of services like code checking, code debugging, your code compilation, and garbage collection. And there are lots of services, more services is gonna provide. Okay, and the second is the .NET framework class library. Third is common language specification, common type system, metadata in assemblies, Windows form, ASP.NET and ASP.NET AJAX, ADO.NET to fetch, you know, data from the SQL server. And we have WF, which is Windows Workflow Foundation, Windows Presentation Foundation, which is nowadays popular in terms of WPF, and Windows Communication Foundation, which is WCF. You might have heard these, you know, abbreviation. And finally, the link queue. Okay, there might be more component I have not mentioned here, but you have to little bit know about this component. So in the next video, we will learn about the Visual Studio, which is an IDE, and I will just create a dummy program there and will show you how to use Visual Studio. Okay, so thank you very much for watching this tutorial. If you like it, then give a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe my channel if you have not subscribed. Okay, bye bye, have a great day.